Today, I'm going to talk about what I've been getting through after the second episode and some videos of my real life. Stay tuned! Hello everyone, this is your girl Mia. If it is your first time on this channel, thank you so much for stopping by. I am stage 4 cancer warrior and I'm currently in the battle. And this YouTube channel is about helping you to be inspired and motivated. I want to be your muse, somebody who empowers you, your life, and hopefully the possibility of your healing. To show your support, please like this video and hit subscribe now. I originally wanted to share the tips for patients, friends, and family, but I've been experiencing depression again recently, so I thought it'd be much more authentic if I share what I'm actually getting through right now. So today, I'll share why my depression got back, what my doctor said about it, and what are the weapons and tools to get through this. I'm also gonna share that what I learned after a couple of dates around Valentine's Day. So my recent depression started a few weeks ago out of nowhere. It was a little mild at first, so I could still be productive. But then beginning of last week, it got a little worse. I've been beating myself up for a few days in front of my computer, trying to make my third episode, but then it didn't really go anywhere because my depression hit me so hard at this point. I said in my first video that I found the balance between my health and work, and I wanted to honor my word. So I tried all my weapons and tools to make myself feel better. That's why I couldn't upload it on time. My apologies. I'll share my actual videos what I've done at the end of this video. I hope you to enjoy. And besides those activities, I went to a couple of dates too. I'll be lying if I said I never thought the cancer would be an obstacle, especially when it comes to the dating world. Although I met my ex-boyfriend when I had stage 2 cancer, and he took care of me for years in every possible way, but I was still a little hesitant because now I have stage 4 cancer, and that's a little different story, right? But anyways, I just jumped into it, and I was really surprised. I realized that I'm still very lovable and desirable, and that made me feel so valuable. It was certainly helpful for my mindset. My dates knew from the beginning with that I still have stage 4 cancer, and all they wanted was having a great time with me. So I confirmed that if you meet the right people, they wouldn't care if you have cancer or not. They will love you as who you are, and they would only want to support you. So if you are single, put yourself out there. Don't let cancer stop you. So now, come back to my depression. Remember I mentioned in my second video that I overcame my depression with Goofy? And now everything is great. My cancer is reducing the size rapidly. I have less pain and more energy than before. I have loving communities. I found God in my life, so I feel fulfilled and I have peace in mind. Then why did my depression came back? I couldn't understand. Maybe purely hormone imbalance? So I talked to my oncologist and she said all my hormones are normal. Then why am I experiencing depression when everything is going great now? She said actually it's common for cancer patients to experience depression, especially who just got through a huge battle or even after the treatment's completed. In my case, I had severe pain, insomnia, nausea, and so on. So I've been focusing on how I feel less pain, have better sleep, or keep the food down. I was living moment by moment, not even day by day. So I couldn't think straight for the whole time. I feel much better so I can think. Now I'm realizing that I just had a life-threatening battle. So that created trauma, which is post-traumatic stress disorder, as known as PTSD. I thought it was only for the veterans who are returning home from war, but then that does make sense, since I had a life-threatening war with cancer. So my doctor suggested an antidepressant for a short period of time so that I can just snap out of it. The medicine takes 4 to 6 weeks to kick in, but in my research, it seems like it does help with depression without so many side effects. So I'll try it out and let you know how it goes. If you're experiencing depression, you're not alone. Globally, more than 264 million of people suffer from depression. So seek for professional help. You have to take care of it as soon as possible. Also, you'll need a lot of weapons and tools to make you feel better and to ease things out. For me, going to a dog park with Goofy, take a walk, meet friends, get some flowers, go to church, sing at a choir helps. What are your weapons? Please share your idea in the comment down below so we can help each other to deal with depression. Thank you so much for checking out this video. So here are my actual some videos. I hope you to enjoy.
I'm trying to make myself feel better with my Goofy. He's my support dog, but he needs support. That's why he's a support dog, not because he's supporting me.
Yeah, I'm not feeling so great today, so I'm gonna go to a dog park with Goofy. Hi, Goofy. Good boy. He doesn't even care. If I can change my mood a little bit. I'm trying everything, meeting friends or going on a date or something like that. So I'm becoming an actual YouTuber. Now I have this tripod at a dog park. With no shame, I'm just gonna do it because this is more important. I gotta record this so that I can share this with you. So yeah, no shame. This is one of my tools to feel a little better, a little uplifting. Yeah, I know it's really hard to get out. It is really hard to get out. But once you're out, you feel better. Did you like it? I have no shame anymore. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and hit subscribe. It helps my cancer journey and also my depression. Thanks for watching. Bisous!